Okay, we'll be looking at the first step. I know Mr. Krishnil has already discussed this in his last Zoom meeting, but I want to just go over it again because I know some students might not have understood it. So first one is balanced function. Now the steps to follow. First one, the first step is if you have to find x-intercept, you will equate the numerator to zero. Right, whatever is in the numerator, put it equal to zero, find the x values. That will be the x-intercepts, right? And then if you have to find the y-intercept, you use the whole equation. In place of x, you put zero. You'll get the y value. And remember, x-intercept, you will put something like this. For example, if your x-intercept comes to 3, put 3 comma 0. That's the intercept. You have to write in coordinate form, right? If your y-intercept comes to, for example, 5, so you'll be putting 0 comma 5 because x is 0, y is 5. Always put in coordinate form, right? After this, you'll see the example. Third step, you find vertical asymptote. Right? How will you find vertical asymptote? By putting the denominator equal to 0. Whatever is in the denominator, put it equal to 0. Now, the vertical asymptote, you will be writing it like this. It says, example, x is equal to 2. So you will not be putting it in coordinate form. Always you'll be putting in this form, x is equal to 2 or y is equal to 2, and so on. Right? I think Flory is raising a hand. Don't worry, I'll give you to talk. Just let me explain it. Next one, to find the horizontal asymptote. Now we are talking about balanced function, right? For balanced function, right, what you do, you divide the coefficient of the highest power, right? So for balanced function, it says find the horizontal asymptote by using the cover-up rule. Write the answer as equations, example y is equal to 1. So if your function is y is equal to x plus 1 into x plus 2 over x plus 3 into x plus 5. So that's a balanced function. How it is a balanced function? Because in the numerator you have 2x. One is x plus 3, one is x plus 2. So when you multiply x and x, you'll get x squared. In the denominator, again, you have 2x. One is x plus 5, one is x plus 3. So when you multiply x and x, you'll get again x squared. Right? So x squared divided by x squared is 1. Or whatever is in front of x squared divided by whatever is in front of x squared is 1. Right? So we'll go over the examples after this. Next one, use a number line to represent all the x values in ascending order to determine the behavior of the graph. Now, you will see you'll be making three graphs, right? Three different types of graphs in one axis. But just because of the asymptotes, x asymptotes and y asymptotes, right? You will be sketching three different types of graphs. Now, how those three graphs will look like, that's what you have to find in step number 5, right? Whether it will fall below the x-axis or whether it will fall above the x-axis, what you have to find. So how we'll find it, we'll look in the example. Okay, let's look at the example. It says I've just taken the example from the worksheet that was given to you people to answer, and most of you got it correct. Most of you got full marks. The function says f of x will be x minus 3 into x plus 1 over x minus 1 into x plus 2. So this is a balanced function. How it is a balanced function? Why we are saying this is a balanced function? Because let me show you. right? Because of you can see x minus 3 and x plus 1, right? X minus 3, x plus 1, right? There are 2x in the numerator, right? When you multiply the both the x, x and x, it will give you x squared, right? And then you can see in the denominator, you can see x minus 1 into x plus 2. If you multiply those two, right? This one, eh? X minus 1 into x plus 2. If you multiply, just multiply the x and the x, you'll get x squared. So x squared over x squared, right? If you get x squared over x squared, right? What is in front of x squared? It's 1, right? There's no other number, right? X squared over x squared. So 1 divided by 1 is 1. That's how horizontal asymptote is 1. You will write y is equal to 1, right? Now, let me just clear this. Now let's look at the solution. First one, to find the x-intercept, right? It says put the numerator equal to 0. Our numerator is x minus 3 and x plus 1. So when you put x minus 3 equal to 0, what do you do? Plus 3 both sides, you'll get answer 3. So how will you write the x-intercept, right? Right, when you put x minus 3 equal to 0, right, plus 3 both sides, your answer will be 3, right? So you will be putting it this way, 3 comma 0, right? And similarly for x plus 1, you will be putting this way, right? Negative 1, 0, right? You minus 1 both sides, you'll get negative 1. And if you find the y-intercept, right, y-intercept, I said, if you are finding the y-intercept, you use the whole equation. In place of x, you put 0. So see, the whole equation was used, right? And in place of x, 0 was placed, right? So 0 minus 3 into 0 plus 1 over 0 minus 1 into 0 plus 2, answer will be 1.5, right? You'll get 1.5. Now, this is how you will put the y-intercept. Right? Because your x was 0, right? Your x was 0 and y is 1.5, comma negative 1.5. Some of you people are making mistake, still making mistake, right? You are just putting 1.5. No, you write in coordinate form like this, always. And then we'll be finding the symptoms though. To find the vertical asymptote, you'll be putting denominator equal to 0, right? And our denominator is x minus 1 and x plus 2. So put x minus 1 equal to 0, plus 1 both sides, you'll get 1, right? Put x plus 2 equal to 0, minus 2 both sides, you'll get negative. Then we find the horizontal asymptote. As I said before, horizontal asymptote, right? You divide the coefficient of the highest power, coefficient of x, similarly. So when you expand x times x, you get x squared. And then x times x in the denominator also x squared. So your horizontal asymptote will be 1. So this is how you will denote your horizontal asymptote, right? See, it will be y is equal to 1, like this. Vertical asymptote x equal to negative 2, not negative 2 comma 0 or 0 comma negative 2, right? Like this. Asymptotes will always be determined, I mean, denoted by this way. I hope all of you are clear. Now, next one. Let's see the graph. Eh? Oh, step 5 is there. Now, to determine which side will be positive, where the start, right? Where the graph will end, where the graph will turn. See, if you see the graph, if you see the graph very properly, you will just hold on. You will see, you can see the graph is already drawn, eh? The vertical asymptotes are there, right? At x equal to -2 and x equal to 1, right? The vertical asymptotes always you will determine with a dotted line. Please remember that, right? You people, I think you people have done it last year, right? In hyperbolic functions, right? So see, this is the vertical asymptote, right? X equal to -2. X equal to -2, and this is another vertical asymptote, x equal to +1, right? This is the horizontal asymptote, x equal to +1. See, now you have to determine how your graph will look like. I mean, for example, you can see this graph is made, this one, right? Why I have made it this way? I could have made it this here. Why the graph is on top there, right? So to determine that, what you do, you know this point is -2. Here it's -2, right? You have -2. So after this number will be -3 here, then -4. So what you do, just put -3 in the original equation, right? Put -3 in the original equation. And you see what you, if your answer is positive, your graph will be up here. If your answer is negative, the graph will be down here like this, the one I drew now, right? Similarly, you check with other points also. For example, here -1, right? Here -1 here. No, -1 is 0 here. Yeah? No problem here. At 1, right? Where will the graph go? It will go up or down, right? Here also, you know, after 1 is 2, then 3, and so on. Now, here, you know, this is a x-intercept, right? Why I have drawn the graph this way, right? You can always check. Put 4, right? Put 4 in place of x, you will get, you'll see whether it's positive or negative. But we are getting positive here, see? You can calculate yourself. I am not, but when you put 4 in place of x in the whole equation, you will get positive value, right? You will get positive value. That means the graph will be up here above the x-axis, right? But not touching this. I should not touch this line. I hope I am clear. Now let me just go over the activity that was given to you. I think most of you got that activity correct, which was good. I had no difficulty in marking. Okay. The activity, first one. F of x is equal to x plus 1 into x plus 4 over x minus 2 or into x plus 2. Now, if you have to find the x and y intercepts, as you know, to find x intercept, put numerator equal to 0. So numerator was x plus 1 and x plus 4. So x plus 1 was put equal to 0, you get -1. When x minus 4 was put equal to 0, x plus 4 was equal to 0, we got -4. How? Just -4 both sides, you'll get -4. And then this is how it was denoted, right? -1, 0 and -4, 0. Right? Just do this separately. X plus 1 equal to 0 and x plus 4 equal to 0, you'll get these answers. right? And then if you, next thing you have to find is the y-intercept, right? Y-intercept in place of x, put 0. So in place of x, you put 0, 0 plus 1 into 0 plus 4 over 0 minus 2 into 0 plus 2, you'll get negative 1. And this is how you will put the y value. Y-intercept as 0 comma negative 1. Next one, you have to find the asymptotes. Right? To find the asymptotes, you put denominator equal to 0. Denominator is x minus 2 and x plus 2. So put x minus 2 equal to 0, you get x equal to 2. Put x plus 2 equal to 0, you get x equal to negative 2. Right? That is how you denote the vertical asymptote. Then horizontal asymptote, as I said, you divide the coefficient of the highest power, right? Meaning you multiply both the x, and x times x is x squared. And in the denominator also, x times x is x squared. So x squared divided by x squared, or whatever is the number in front of it, right? You'll get the answer. You'll get 1. Right? I hope you are clear on this. Next one, the graph. Right? This is what you will get. And this is the graph you will get. You can see our vertical asymptote is this one. Right? At negative 2, there is a dotted line. At 2, there is a dotted line. Right? And then at 1, there is a dotted line. This is the horizontal asymptote. Right? Now, why I have drawn the graph here? Because this was the x-intercept here. That's why the graph is this way. And it will never touch this one. Eh? It will always go like this and parallel to this. And then why this graph is up here? Why? Why it is not down here? Because when you put here last number is 2, you put 3 in place of x in the whole equation, you'll get a positive answer. If you get a positive answer, the graph will be up here. If you get a negative answer, then you draw the graph down here. And this one, you know, this is the x-intercept, this is the y-intercept. You just join in, and this is the graph you'll get. But I hope you, all of you are clear on this. Now, let me go to the next one. I know most of you want to learn about bottom-heavy function. I know I'm quite fast, but just because of time constraint, please bear with me. Now, second one is type 2. That is a bottom-heavy function. Right? Bottom-heavy function, I think this is the second worksheet that was given to you on this. Now, let me go over it. It says, when the denominator of a rational function is higher degree, then numerator, it is called a bottom heavy function, meaning that in the denominator, the power of x is greater than the one in the numerator, right? For example, in the numerator is x, in the denominator is x squared, so it's a bottom heavy function, because in the denominator is x squared, in the numerator is x, the power of x in the numerator is 1, the power of x in the denominator is 2. Right? Then, so we'll be using the same steps, similar steps. First one, to find the x-intercept, you put numerator equal to 0. Same steps, just like the one we used in the balance function. Second step, to find y-intercept, you put x equal to 0. And then to find vertical asymptote, 0, horizontal asymptote, remember, for bottom heavy function, horizontal asymptote, you don't have to find. It will always be equal to 0. Don't have to find anything. No calculation needed. Okay? Just write down horizontal asymptote, y is equal to 0. Then you have to use the number line to find the where the graph will fall. Eh? Whether the graph will be above the x-axis or below the x-axis. Okay? So similar steps. Only difference is, what's the only difference? Is just the horizontal asymptote, right? In balance function, we were dividing the coefficient of x of the highest power, and we are finding the horizontal asymptote. But in bottom AE function, we will not find any horizontal asymptote, because for bottom AE function, horizontal asymptote is 0. Now, next one, let's see the example. It says our rational function is given as f of x is equal to x plus 3 over x minus 3 into x plus 2. Now, why we say this is a bottom heavy function? Why? Because you can see in the numerator is x plus 3 only. Only one x is there. Right? The power of x is 1. But in the denominator, there are 2x, which is one is x minus 3, another one is x plus 2. Right? You can see this. So when you multiply this x with this x, you'll get x squared. So in the denominator, you'll get x squared. In the numerator is only x. So this is a bottom heavy function. Why bottom heavy? Because the denominator is heavy. Right? The power of x more in the denominator. Now, to find the x and y intercepts, to find the x intercept, you let numerator equal to 0. Just like what we did in balance function, x plus 3 equal to 0, minus 3 both sides, you get x equal to negative 3, right? And then you put x intercept is negative 3 comma 0. Y intercept, similarly, in place of, you use the whole equation, in place of x, put 0, right? When you put 0 in place of x, the final answer you get is negative half or negative 0.5. So you'll be putting it this way. Y-intercept is 0 comma negative 0.5. Now, identify the asymptotes. If it says identify the asymptotes, that means you have to find the vertical asymptote and horizontal asymptote. Okay? So vertical asymptote, denominator equal to 0, right? X minus 3 equal to 0. So when you solve that, plus 3 both sides, you will get x equal to 3. And then x plus 2 equal to 0, you'll get x minus x equal to negative 2. And as I said, bottom heavy function, the horizontal asymptote is y is equal to 0 always. Don't have to find. But if it comes in the exam that find the asymptotes, make sure you write it. That horizontal asymptote y is equal to 0. Vertical asymptote, you find that and write it. X equal to 3 and x equal to negative 2. Now, let's look at the graph. Now, what I have done here is I have drawn the vertical asymptote, which is x equal to 3, right? Then the another one is x equal to negative 2, right? There is no horizontal asymptote. The horizontal asymptote is this line, yeah, this one, right? Y is equal to 0. So don't have to put a dotted line there, because that's a x-axis. Eh? Now, I have used this to see where our graph will fall. Right? Some places you will know the graph will fall here. For example, you know negative 3, 0 is a x-intercept. Right? And 0, negative 0.5 is the y-intercept. So you will know. Since this is the x-intercept, the graph will definitely come like this and go up. It will not go down. Why? Because this is the horizontal asymptote. The graph has to go parallel to this horizontal asymptote. That's why it came down and moved up. And you can turn it around from somewhere down here and then go up and go parallel to this one. The horizontal asymptote, right? And then if you look at this one, the y-intercept, right? You just draw the graph, go through this point and turn somewhere around here and go parallel to this vertical asymptote, right? This one will go parallel to this one, and this one will go parallel to this one. Now The problem is this graph, the last one. Okay. I would have drawn the graph here. But why I have not drawn? Because of this. See, right? When I place 3 in place of x, in place of x here, right? All the x, I have placed 3, the answer I got was positive. It was positive something. So when it, if it comes to positive, when I placed more than 3, if I placed 4, right? The answer I got was positive. That means when x is 4 here, right, the answer is positive. The graph is up here. That's why the graph is up here. Right? It's not down here. Right. So this is the final graph that you will get. And remember, balance function and bottom wave function, the steps are similar. Only difference is the the horizontal asymptote, right? In balance function, horizontal asymptote, you divide the coefficients. In bottom wave function, the horizontal asymptote is always zero. That's the difference, right? I hope you people are finding it easy to use the graph, and you will definitely send me the correct graph soon. Some of you have not submitted the second worksheet to me. Now I will not go over the exercise because that's what you have to do and submit. Right. So now what I will do, I will just turn you people on so that you people can ask me questions if you have. Right, one by.